The first class is Druid. It is a class that is meant to be balanced, not in terms of power, but in terms of offense and defense. Many Druid cards have an option to be played in two different ways. These cards use what's known as the Choose One mechanic. This usually allows the player to use the card offensively, to deal more damage to the opponent, or defensively, to protect the hero or other minions. This is also reflected in Druid's hero ability, which gives your hero plus 1 attack this turn and grants you plus 1 armor. It is not as strong offensively as some of the other hero powers, and it doesn't give you too much defense, but the ability to get both makes it more flexible. Flexibility is a big part of playing Druid, and another way to be flexible is to manipulate your mana crystals. Gaining extra mana crystals is a specialty of the Druid class, and cards like Wildgrowth, Nourish or Innervate allow Druid to ramp up their mana. By investing a card and spending the mana early, you're then able to reap the rewards by having more mana than your opponent on the following turns. Ramping does cost cards, and to make up for that, Druid has powerful yet expensive card draw tools such as Nourish and Ultimate Infestation. This also makes it possible to rely on more expensive cards than you'd normally want for a smooth mana curve, because as a Druid, you'll usually have more mana to play with than any other class. Having extra mana, powerful card draw and flexibility, Druids usually play mid-range and control decks which rely on using expensive cards earlier than their opponents, and aggro or token decks which rely on buffed minions to overwhelm their opponent. While Druid is great at many playstyles, they have some holes in their toolkit. Their removal is definitely lacking, which means that Druid has to take advantage of their mana gain and get ahead early on, because it is difficult for them to come back from a disadvantage otherwise.